Jack and Jill were walking up the hill to the bar on the outskirts of town. Jill started crying 'cause she knew Jack was lying about the porn he was watching when she wasn't around. They got to the bar and there was no one there except a woman behind the counter who gave him a glare. Miss Muffet's the name and you can call me the same, and I'm just waiting for the cook to bring my curds and whey. So she poured their beers, then the cook appeared with her curds and whey. He said, around here they call me Humpty Dumpty. Miss Muffet sat down on one of the stools. They all started chatting. Old Dumpty the fool got up on the bar and he started to dance. He almost fell off, but then by chance Jack Be Nible came running in quick, in his hand a candlestick. Humpty was falling and Jack took that candle, shoved it up Humpty's hole. Now he had a handle. At the moment of fear, the man appeared with his candle in hand. Jack helped Humpty stand on the bar again. It was cheering and Dumpty was clapping. In all the commotion, still something amiss. A spider coming down to give Miss Muffet a kiss. Miss Muffet threw a bowl up into the air, hit Jack in the head, knocked him off his chair. Jill slapped that spider right off of Muffet's face, and everything out that place. So it appeared Jack's candle turned Humpty queer. With a grin and a clap, Humpty knew Muffet lied to be slapped. And his fat wife Joan pulled up in their car to that bar. Little Jack Horner turned the corner from Banbury Cross on a cock horse. A minute later, that's when four Jacks hit the bar on the hill on the outskirts of town. Miss Muffet gave Jill a wink and poured them four Jacks around. Humpty was still dancing with a candle in his hole. Joan broke out some clothes and an old time rock and roll. Everybody's nose is stung, got into that stuff. But Jill was looking like she had enough. Just on the spot, it walked over to Jill and gave her a kiss, and time stood still. Miss Muffet said, "There ain't no harm to quit being a school bar." Something inside Jill changed that night. A fire beneath her dampened light. kissed her. She wanted all and missed her. Poor Jack's in some damn fine hands. But the Queen of Hearts just made it better. Jill took it all off and laid on the table. And in a minute, them Jacks were willing and able. Humpty kept on dancing. His Muffet found her thrill. Took it all off too. Climbed on top of Jill. Jill was filming it all while working her eight ball. His Muffet's fluffy muff was stuffed in Jill's mouth. The Jacks were around the table working it out. Muffet munching Jill, they thought it all come true. And Georgie Porgie walked into that orgy. When Georgie walked in, it was something to see. He got up on the bar with a Humpty. He took that candle by the other end. And now he and Humpty were but friends. So Jack and Jack, and Jack and Jack, Jack on the back of the Chillin' Muffet snack stack. Jill played her hand with Queen of Hearts. Humpty had her beat right from the start. But no one in there had to fold. It was a Humpty who played Georgie, his ace in the hole.